A buddy of mine had an idea for a job that he said I could make a lot of money at and still have a flexible schedule. And I was like, well, that sounds great. Sign me up. He left out the fact that it was an insane thing to do for money. And so for a brief period of time in my life, I was a character on Hollywood Boulevard. Correct response. Green Day couldn't handle that Boulevard of Broken Dreams. Horrible. I was Big Bird in front of the Chinese theater. If you're wondering why I was Big Bird, it's because I'm tall and my friend was the Cookie Monster. I can't explain everything. You know what I mean? Guys, we gotta keep going here. Yeah, it was terrible. The worst thing that ever happened was a couple of dudes came up to me and I wasn't sure if they wanted a photo with Big Bird or if they wanted to stab Big Bird. One of them called me the C word, which is my least favorite word in the world. I think it's disgusting. It makes me feel bad, like it hurts my heart. I hate it so much. I tried to write a joke about it, but in order to like write a joke about something, you have to kind of be able to zoom out on it and, you know, kind of see it with like a fresh perspective. And if you do that with the C word, you realize it's just like any other word. It's just a series of symbols that have been arranged in a particular order that we all agreed on the meaning of. So we all got together and we're like, this particular thing is going to be a derogatory term for a vagina. And I know that cognitively, but I still choose not to say it because every time I do, it feels like I'm skipping a little closer to the fiery chasms of a hell that I don't even think I really believe in anymore. And I think what's happening there is because of the life that I've lived in certain ways and in sort of the mistakes that I've made, that like voluntary reverence toward the C word is just one tiny way I can maintain a small shred of that innocent boy that I used to be in Florida. And I think that's where a lot of my psychology kind of like really comes into play. Where was I? Oh yeah, so I'm inside this Big Bird costume and this guy calls me the C word, which was offensive. And so I said to him, and this time, by the way, I spoke in Big Bird's voice because as a performer, I'm always evolving. And so he calls me that and then I just go, do you suck your mom's dick with that mouth? No, it's not good. It's horrible. It's a horrible thing to say. It doesn't even make sense, actually. It's just a vile, gross thing. But I did say that. And then his friend goes, yo, faggot! And my first thought was like, even in here, really. Just can't escape it. He goes, yo, faggot! My friend here is a former Marine. And I was like, oh no. And so then I just go, oh, I'm so sorry. And please forgive me. And thank you for your service. Because Big Bird is nothing if not patriotic. And then the former United States Marine then said to Sesame Street's Big Bird, stop me if you've heard this one before. I'm going to go back to my car and I'm going to get a knife. And if you're still here when I get back, you're dead. And I almost said, well, how far away is your car? But what I did instead was I ran away. So all that to say, if you were on Hollywood Boulevard like 7 or 8 years ago, there's a very significant chance that you may have seen like a 7.5 foot tall, perfectly manicured, yellow feathered bird just like booking it down the street like, with his beady little eyes bouncing back and forth. And if you saw that undoubtedly hilarious image, for that image and for so many other things in American life, you should thank our military because they do more than we would ever realize.